you did last year. What kind of drove you to that decision?
Like with the drills and stuff?
Yeah, doing fullback.
No, I when I trained, I did mostly just defensive stuff, and I just worked on linebacker. But when this morning they asked me if I'd do some fullback, running back stuff, so I didn't think I'd be doing some jump cuts, but, you know, I can jump in there, and I was happy to do it, whatever they need.
This looks like the same playbook that Nick was going through a year ago, and, you know, trying to do both and market himself. Does that appeal to you?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I mean, I knew that'd be an opportunity to me, you know, because I played on offense and I played on defense, so I knew that there'd be teams that are interested in the offensive side. So, you know, the more I can show, the more I can do, you know, it just really helps me out and shows my versatility, and I was happy to do whatever they asked.
You said you were training defensively. Is your training changed now that worked a little bit more fullback today?
You know, not too much. I mean, you know, I feel like, you know, a lot of the fullback stuff just comes natural to me, and, you know, just running routes and those kind of drills. So, you know, I definitely will do, you know, some more offensive stuff, catch some more balls if I have to. But my main focus is linebacker, unless the team says, you know, they want me there. And wherever I end up going, you know, I'll adjust accordingly.
Is it hard? I mean, you knew somebody might ask you to do something, but yet, you know, you feel like you need to focus all your time, obviously, on one position. Is that a hard battle to try to decide how much to do, you know, how much to work on one thing compared to the other and manage it all?
I mean, it's pretty tough, but at the end of the day, you know, it just comes down to, you know, balance and coordination and just being able to, you know, see what they're telling you to do and then do it. And, you know, I feel like that's the biggest thing. And, you know, it takes a football player and an athlete, and I feel like, you know, I combine with both of those. So it's hard, you know, just because you got to, when you're training, you're like, all right, I did this, now I got to go do this. And, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I'm willing to do whatever it takes. And, you know, like when the coaches move me here, you know, it's just I'll do it and I'll just keep moving on. So
what kind of feedback did you get from them, especially from the offensive staff?
Yeah, I got a lot of good feedback. You know, the team seemed interested in me and wanted to talk more. And I think I opened some eyes today. You know, people maybe not looking at me until today. And, you know, I felt good about the day. I felt strong and just hope for the best and pray for the best.
Since you weren't at the combine, was this maybe a more important day for you than maybe some of the
Oh, definitely. You know, they had already put up their numbers a little. So this morning I was giving them a hard time. Like, hey, y'all aren't nervous. And I was sitting there shaking when I was running my 40. You know, it was just the little jitters, little butterflies. I mean, to be honest with you, a little bit more nervous than I am, you know, before a game, because it just comes naturally and everybody's watching you here. But, you know, it was a huge day for me, and I've been training for 12 weeks for it, and I'm glad it's over and just get a little rest.
Glad it's over, but were you pleased with what you got done in terms of your times, what you jumped, what you lifted, and all that? Did you meet kind of your expectations?
Yeah, I mean, I met most of my expectations on most of the lifts. You know, some of the things are the drills, and some of the things could have done better, I thought. But, you know, it's something that I just got to move forward with, and I'll take what I get, and, you know, hopefully that's good enough for the teams.
What kind of expectations do you have, goals for draft day and stuff like that?
Be honest with you, I mean, obviously I want to get drafted. I want to, it'd be a dream of mine, and it'd be awesome. But at the end of the day, I just want to make a camp, because when you make the camp, it's a clean slate, and that's when it starts. And so as long as I get that opportunity to get on a team and show what I got and represent the University of Tennessee, that's what I'll have to do.
You've been working out in Nashville, right?
I've been working at D1 in Nashville.
Are you going back there, staying here?
I think I'm going to stay here for a little bit, you know, work here and see how it goes, because our trainer there is, you know, going to take a little bit of vacation, so probably just come back here. Good.